Tribhuvan from Department of Computer Science and Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. And today we shall see how to solve the graph coloring problem by backtracking approach. Now, we shall see what exactly is the graph coloring problem. How does backtracking approach provide a solution to this problem and how to solve this problem by backtracking approach. So at the end of the session, you will be able to apply backtracking approach to solve the graph coloring problem. Now, what exactly is the problem? In this problem, we are given a connected graph having n number of nodes and m number of colors. The objective of the problem is to find out whether all the nodes of graph G are colored in such a way that no two adjacent nodes are colored with the same color. That means if I'm coloring a particular node VI with a color, say for example red, then I cannot color any other node which is adjacent to node VI by the same red color. And the second constraint is that all the nodes of the graph are colored with at most m colors. That means I cannot use more than m colors because I only have m colors in my hand. So this is termed as the m colorability decision problem. We find out whether the graph can be colored with m colors or not. So the backtracking approach provides a solution to this particular problem. We generate a state space tree for all the possibilities of the solution, and then we limit the growth of the tree by bounding the solution path if the adjacent nodes have similar color. Now consider the graph given below. It has 5 nodes which have been noted as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We have been given 3 colors, that is RGB, standing for red, green and blue, and we have to find whether the given graph can be colored in at most 3 colors or not. Now we shall apply backtracking approach, generate the state space tree for the solution and find out whether this graph can be colored with 3 colors or not. We shall see how it is done. Now this is the exact graph that we had seen. It has 5 nodes which has been named, the nodes have been named from 1 through 5, and we shall see how to solve this problem using backtracking. Now initially we start with the initial node, and now we want to see whether the first, we start coloring the nodes by the given colors. So firstly, I color node 1 with red, so I state x1, that is node 1 colored with red. So now I have 3 options to color node 2. So if I color node 2 with R, that is red, this is incorrect, because no adjacent nodes can be colored with the same color. So this is not possible. So I have to take the second color, that is green. So I can color the second node with green. So first node or the first vertex has been colored with red. The second vertex has been colored with green. Now I continue further with coloring the further nodes. Now I have to check whether node 3 can be colored with red or green or blue. So I start with red. So coloring node 3 with red is not possible because we have already colored node 1 with red, which is again adjacent to node 3. So since node 1 has been colored with red, I cannot color node 3 with red. Similarly, I cannot color it with green because node 2 is already colored with green, which is again adjacent to node 3. So node 3 cannot be colored with green. I have one color left, which is blue. So I write as third node is colored with blue. So first node is colored with red, second node is colored with green, third node is colored with blue. Now I have to check for the fourth node. So I start with the first color, that is red. So is it possible? Yes, because node 3 is colored with blue and node 5 is not yet colored, so it is possible for me to color fourth node with red. Now I have the last node remaining, which is node 5. So I will start coloring, or the solution, I will start with red. Is it possible? No, because node 4 is already colored with red. Can I color it with green? Yes, it is possible to color node 5 with green, because the two adjacent nodes of node 5, that is node 4 and node 1, are having different colors. And since we know that node 1 has red color, node 4 has also red color, and node 5 should have some different color than red. And since I am coloring it with green, so this is my solution. So the first solution that I have come across is color the first node with red, color the second node with green, color the third node with blue, color the fourth node with red again, and color the fifth node with green, which gives me the solution. Now I can trace back, I can backtrack and find the other solutions for this same problem. Now I have colored the fifth node with green. Is there any other solution? We shall check. Now if I color the fifth node with red, is over, it cannot be colored. Green is what we have done in the previous solution. If I color it with blue, I come to know that this is my second solution, because both 1 and 4 have been colored with red, and I can color node 5 with blue. So this is the other solution that I am getting for this particular problem, that node 1 can be colored with red, node 2 can be colored with green, node 3 can be colored with blue, node 4 again can be colored with red, and node 5 can be colored with blue. So these are the two solutions that we are getting at this point in time. Of course, if you generate the entire tree and search for the entire search space, you will get all the solutions. That is, you will get all the possible solutions for this particular graph, where we can color it with these three colors. We shall stop here. So we have seen two solutions where we color the five nodes of this graph by three colors. So at this point in time, I want you to pause the video and find whether we can color this graph, which is having four nodes, with three colors. Pause the video and find out whether the graph can be colored with these three colors or not. So if you have applied the backtracking approach and you have found out the solution, you will find out that yes, you can color this graph with three nodes. What you have to consider is that you are not coloring any two adjacent vertices with the same color. Say for example, you color the first node with red, then you have the option to color the second node with green or blue. I will consider it as green. Then you can color the third node with red again, and then you can color the fourth node with blue. So you have the option, and you have the options to color it with three nodes, and you can come to many possibilities. I have already discussed one possibility with you, and you can color it with given three colors. So this is the reference that I have used for this video lecture. Thank you.